Our method is really different from the usual methods that people use to map out brain wiring. Usually what people do is in a mouse or some other lab organism, they inject some kind of a tracer in one brain area, and that tracer spreads to other brain areas. So that tracer will typically have a color, let's say green. A common way to do it these days is with something called GFP or green fluorescent protein. You inject the GFP into one part of the brain, wait a few days, and then wherever in the brain you see that green, you know that those neurons send their wires to that place. The problem with that method is that it labels all the neurons within an area with green, and so you can't tell that one particular neuron goes to one place and one particular neuron goes, a different neuron goes to a different place. And so what we've done that's fundamentally different is rather than treating the problem of brain wiring as a problem of microscopy, we've engaged a new technology that is revolutionizing other branches of biology but hasn't really been used in this way before, which is high-throughput DNA sequencing, the same technology that was used to determine the sequence of the human genome that nowadays makes it possible to figure out the genome sequence of a person for $1,000. We're piggybacking off of that same technology and using DNA barcodes instead of colors. With this method, in a single experiment, we can do the amount of work that would previously have required months or years of work of systematic, careful, and laborious study. Furthermore, the cost of this method is much, much lower than the traditional methods, not only because of the labor saved, but because sequencing, the cost of sequencing is plummeting at a truly impressive rate. So that originally 15 years ago, it cost over $1 billion to sequence the human genome, and today it costs under $1,000, and in a few years it'll probably cost under $100. So we benefit from the tremendous efficiencies that arise from high-throughput DNA sequencing.